folks. So I wanted to update a quick guide that we already had on how to install Google Analytics and WordPress, and it's because I think there is a new, better answer out there for this job, so I wanted to show that off for you. So I've got this website where I've been using this plugin called Exact Metrics. It's kind of bothering me with this banner, and I never loved it that much to begin with, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that plugin. GadWP is what it is. Switching to a different plugin. No thanks, I won't tell you. So I'm going to remove that plugin. That little pop-up, by the way, is one of the reasons I decided to get rid of it. And I'm going to use a plugin created by Google itself, who owns Google Analytics, as you might guess. So I'm going to install a plugin called Site SpaceKit by Google. So if I do a search for that, I will find SiteKit by Google. Indeed, it tells me it's by Google. And so this is one of the many reasons I like it. Google has plenty of reasons to make SiteKit good, and they aren't selling you something, and that I find very nice. There are plenty of complicated moral ethical questions around Google itself in the world, all that stuff. But if you're choosing Google Analytics, you're choosing affirmatively to use Google, and that's how I do it on most of my websites. So I'm going to install and activate SiteKit. And with that running, it is honestly one of the simplest, best ways I've found to install Google Analytics, and it can give you some extra power-ups with regard to Google. So I'll go ahead and let them collect my data, because they already are, let's be honest. And then I'm going to sign in with Google to this site, and this is a core part of the auth flow. I'm going to pick my account. I'm going to allow it access. Again, all of this makes sense and is exactly what you would expect from any Google Analytics plugin. I need to let it in, and then I can go back to the WordPress dashboard. All right, so I've just set up Google Search Console. Separately, I can connect Analytics. So by default, SiteKit is for Search Console, but you can just use it very quickly and easily for analytics. So I will now click Connect Service again. Again, use that same account I just used. Allow Google to have access to Google's data. And there we go, I've set up Google Analytics. With that, Google just emailed me that I did this. I can hit Configure Your Analytics. And the one thing that I'm pretty sure the settings here are always the way I want them to be, but let me double check that. So in settings, analytics, I can double check. You can see that it says snippet is inserted. So if you were running a different Google Analytics plugin and wanted to use SiteKit, you could actually turn off the snippet is inserted thing by just editing the settings here, and you can just click it off. But I'm letting Google place the code on my site because that's actually why I'm installing it. So again, why am I doing this? Well, it's because Google Search Console is this really useful tool if you're relying on some percentage of your traffic to come from Google searches. So on this website I run as kind of hobby, non-WordPress programming, I've got this article on rubber duck debugging that does pretty well in Google search results pages or PHP namespaces. And you can also see, that was my Search Console results, you can also see my analytics results. I have a really high bounce rate on the site, maybe I should work on that. But that's kind of, this is a hobby site, I'm not going to worry about it. But that is kind of how all of this fits together. And so the beautiful thing about analytics in SiteKit is that you're getting Google charts of how Google thinks you should present their data, rather than how one of these other Google Analytics plugins that you can totally use and they work totally well think you should see your data. And I actually really like the way Google wants me to see this data and what it shows me here. So this is my preferred Google Analytics plugin today in 2020, Google SiteKit. Cheers.